Hi, this is Graham from Jenham's Astro. Today we're going to be unboxing a new telescope. This is the Skywatcher Skymax 127, which is a 127mm Maksutov telescope. In the UK, it's for sale for around £250 for the optical tube assembly. So let's open up the box and take a look. Okay, so we open up the box. And typically in Skywatcher fashion, there's a box within a box. So we'll open up this one as well. Okay, so what have we got? So we've got a couple of leaflets. So we've got an instruction manual, Astronomical Telescope User Guide. We've got a flyer, which has got various Skywatcher models. And we've got an instruction manual. Now this is pretty lightweight. It's basically one side, two sides of English, and in this case, two sides of German instructions. And from what I can tell, it's largely explaining how to attach the red dot finder to the telescope. Other than that, we can see that we've got a couple of boxes here, and then we've got a case, which is quite nice. So if we open up the case, take that out of the box, and then we can see what's inside. So we'll come back to the box and its contents later. So hopefully you can see it's quite a nice black carry case, and it's got the name Skywatcher here on the side, and it's got a carry handle and a zip pocket on the side, and it also comes with a strap, so you can quite imagine carrying the optical tube assembly around in this carrier. So if we have a look inside. Zip. Okay, so the telescope itself is well packed on delivery, and if we take out the tube, so here we go. So removing the packaging, we've got a layer of plastic, and we've got some bubble wrap. Some tissue paper. So if we put all that aside, then there it is, the Skywatcher Skymax 127. Well, it feels a nice size. One of the things I'm hoping to do is compare this telescope with another one that you see quite a lot on my channel, which is the Celestron C90. So straight away you can see that is the comparison in size. The 127's quite a bit heavier, we'll weigh it in a while, but also I'd say comparing this to the Skymax 150, which I've also used and reviewed on this channel, it's a much more manageable size, and I'm interested to see how it compares fitting between the C90 and the 150. Okay, so let's have a closer look. So first off, you'll see we've got a Vixen style dovetail rail attached to the bottom of the optical tube. So that's going to fit on standard mounts. We've got, as you've probably come to expect from Skywatcher, we've got a standard finder bracket here. And the scope is supplied with a lens cover. So if we just take that off gently, here we are, plastic lens cover. So there we are, there is the front, the correct plate on the front of the 127. Now let's have a look. So I can note that there are one or two very small spots here where the paint has flaked off, and I noticed that exactly the same with the 150 when I unboxed that, and it's no big deal. I guess it just doesn't quite adhere fully all the way around. Some tiny little spots, but I guess it's not really a big deal. Other than that, I can't see any dust or debris inside the tube, so that's quite promising. And the finish is rather nice. It comes, as with all Skywatcher scopes, comes with a warning basically not to look at the sun, and pretty obvious really, but good advice. And then if we look at the rear of the tube, we can see that we've got a focuser knob, which has quite a nice feel to it. It's quite stiff, but probably we need to move a little bit of grease around inside the focuser. But it's a good sort of feel to that. And then we have, if we take loosen these two screws, right, we've got the visual back. Now, this telescope is supplied with a 1¼-inch accessory, so this visual back is ready to accept a diagonal, which we'll see in a minute, is also included inside the package. And the other thing to note is that on the end of this thread, it will fit onto a T-ring. So this is exactly the same as on the back of the C90, which perhaps isn't a surprise given the origin of these two scopes. So if you've got a DSLR and you buy one of these, a T-ring, to fit your particular brand of camera, then you can screw that onto the back of your telescope very easily and attach a camera. So that's a really useful feature. It's much more securely held than some alternative fittings, and it's good to see that it's available on the 127 as well as on the C90. Okay, let's do a couple of weight tests. So I've got my scales here. If I put the 127 onto the scales, it's telling me that it's topping at 3.3 kilos for the 127. And if I compare that with the C90, then it's telling me that that is 1.9 kilos. So it's quite a lot heavier, but it doesn't feel unmanageably so. Compare that with the Skymax 150, and that is around about 6 kilos once you put the diagonal on the back. So the 150 feels like a much bulkier scope, whereas this is definitely more my idea of grab and go. Okay, so let's see what else is in the package. So going back to the box, you recall that there were two boxes within the box. So the first one, I think, is really just for padding. There's nothing in there. And then this one has got the remaining accessories. So if we open this one up, so what have we got? Well, firstly, we've got a red dot finder. Now, anybody who's watched one of my recent videos on the Skywatcher Heritage 130 will recognize this. It is the same red dot finder, which works very well with the little Dobsonian, and I'm sure it will work well with the Skymax. Skywatcher obviously chosen to use the red dot finder approach rather than fitting a 50mm optical finder scope, which is the sort of approach they've taken with the larger Skymax 150. But from experience, this is a good little lightweight red dot finder, and the idea is, of course, that it will slot onto the tube here on the bracket. So that's very easy to attach, and all you really need to do is to pull off the battery cover, put it onto the scope, and make a one-time alignment of the red dot finder. And what's interesting is that inside the box, Skywatcher have already thought of the tools you need for this, and they provided a screwdriver which will allow you to adjust the pointing of the red dot finder so that it's lined up with the main tube of the Skymax 127. Other than that, we've got a, hopefully you can see that, we've got a diagonal mirror, 90 degree diagonal. Again, everything comes in plastic bags. So there you go, it's a 1¼ inch 90 degree diagonal. If we unscrew the end cap, which is a little bit stiff, we'll see that it just uses two screws to fit around the eyepiece. There's no compression ring, so it's pretty basic, I guess. It's very lightweight, and it is a mirror. It's a mirror diagonal, but certainly that'll get you started. And then finally, there are two eyepieces inside the box. Now, these are the same eyepieces as are supplied with the 130 Heritage scope. So one of them is described as a Super 25, so it's a 25mm wide-angle lens eyepiece with long eye relief, according to the label. And the other one is a Super 10, also with long eye relief. Now, from my experience of these two eyepieces, I'd say that they're okay, really. I mean, given that Skywatcher are obviously building the package to a price, then the 25 is a pretty useful little eyepiece. Certainly get you going. You can see comes with end caps, and it's got a nice rubber eye grip there, so just to shade your eye from stray light and to give you a bit more comfortable view. So I'd say the two eyepieces, the 25 and the 10, we can work out what magnification we're going to get with those two, given that this scope has a, I believe, a 1500mm focal length. Yep, that's right. So it's an f12 scope, so we can work out the magnifications we're going to get with the 25 and the 10. But certainly they're going to be good to get you started in combination with the diagonal. So we can put all that together. Quite tight fit. Tighten up the eyepiece. Take the tube. Loosen off the two screws. And there you go. So all you've got to do is attach the red dot finder which will go in here. A little bit fiddly, so I'll do that afterwards. There we go. And that's it. So I'd say first impressions, Skymax 127. It's a nice size of telescope. Definitely grab and go, according to my definition. Has a nice quality feel about it. The only comment being those flecks of paint, which is to say is no big deal. Nice quality finish on the tube. Good weighting to the focuser. So I'm looking forward to comparing the performance of the scope with the C90 and also with the Skymax 150 to see if it fits a nice spot in the range of telescope sizes. My experience with the 150 was that it was a little bit too heavy to use as a grab and go. Other people disagree, and certainly the 90mm C90 has provided with some fantastic views. So interested to compare the results of the Skymax 127 in future videos. Okay, so thanks for watching. See you again.